have just begun.
Catch the dream. The fire inside.
The dream has not. It started long before. In towns like this one. On frozen lakes. On frozen ponds. Where nature's molecules form the training ground. For young blades to first cut the ice, this is a life on the edge. Journey of dedication, passion, and fortitude. This is the code of the game. Learn from towns like War Road. Their motto is simple. Come early, stay late, skate every day. Where that road leads is the place where dreams come true.
There's a sound in every city. Similar, but specific to a team.
The goal horn is a uniquely hockey celebration.
Everyone's got a different goal horn, but ours is definitely the best.
It's a rallying cry.
Especially in the playoffs. The more we hear it, the better.
Calling a fan base to action.
Chuck Devitt has my ringtone.
I'm never tired of hearing the goal horn.
Everybody just goes crazy.
Get energy from the building.
It's massively loud.
It literally can shake the foundation. You can hear it outside.
When and where a tradition began is often debated. But there are certain customs whose origins can easily be traced. 1973 Stanley Cup Finals, Montreal, Chicago. Blackhawks owner Bill Wirtz installs the horn of his yacht inside Chicago's home rink.
Chicago Stadium, Golden Wire.
The new ritual in the National Hockey League was born. The goal horn has become ubiquitous. Every sound is unique, but together they provide the score for what's to come.
Center, number 28.
Oilers and Flames in the playoffs for the first time in three decades, and the potential of this series feels like it's off the charts. For the seventh time in eight playoff games, Oilers start with the McDavid line, and they'll face the Gaudreau line. So it's best on best to start game number one. Chris Cuthbert and Craig Simpson are ready with the call on opening night of this second round. First at Scotiabank Saddledome, we go to Iceland.
And join the singing voice of her Calgary Flames and multiple Canadian Country Music Award winner, George Kanyon, accompanied by Flames organist Willie Jewson and members of the Calgary EMS in the singing of our national anthem.
One fierce rivalry, and one team will become the last Canadian club standing with a berth in the Western Conference Championship Series at stake. The Oilers and Flames, back to the future. Game one from Scotiabank Saddledome. There's Mike Smith, who closed out the Los Angeles Kings with a seven-game shutout Saturday night. His second whitewash of round number one. And at the other end, Vezina finalist Jacob Markstrom surrendered only four goals in four home games in the Flames' seven-game series victory over Dallas. Alberta, Craig Simpson, are you ready for this?
Absolutely. You know, both these teams coming off emotional Game 7 wins get right back into the starter's gate. And I love it, the fact the coaches give you exactly what you want. Two of the best lines in hockey, 301 points for the Calgary Flames, 274 for this line for the Oilers. Game on.
Elias Lindholm, Connor McDavid to face it off. Yamamoto and Draisaitl for the Oilers.
A critical game for both sides here, and we are underway. Oh, a clutch save!
Smith somehow able to make this save. I think from my position that this is going in the net, but he gets just enough of it.
Tremendous blocker stop by Markstrom. Toffoli swooping in on the attack. And that's deflected. And he makes the save. Wrist shot from the slot. There's another stop.
I love the way that he's in position, and he's got the reflexes to bang out a couple of stops in a row.
Takes a blast. And the shot dies in the traffic jam. Coming down the left wing and into the zone. And here at center, that's intercepted. Puck picked up by Nurse. Calgary's got a hold of it against the wall. Here's a blast! Off target!
Not really close with it. What a shot! He scores!
Oh, man, the goalie thought he had this covered, James. You can tell from his body language, but it beats him, hits the post, and goes in.
So many ebbs and flows to a playoff series. It's kind of nice to get the first goal, give your team the upper foot here early on.
The Flames tally the game's first goal.
When you get yourself into the middle part of a period, this is where the game starts to take shape, and now they've got the lead.
Takes the feed in the middle of the ice. That's gloved by Smith. We got a whistle as the puck's frozen.
Kachuk's tricky zone ability is that creativity and the skill to try new and unconventional plays that most players wouldn't even try in practice. That unpredictability is what helps him generate highlight reel scoring chances.
Here's a shot. Oh, and it stays out. He got a piece of that one. There's the whistle. Offside is the call, stopping the play. Getting closer to the halfway point of this frame. Calgary's ahead 1-0. Edmonton's won the draw, and they take possession here in the open ice. Tried to connect the pass, but it doesn't go. Barry's lugging the puck. And now it's grabbed by Monahan. The official signaling for a penalty as play is called. He's going off for tripping, and doesn't everybody feel like they're innocent on a trip?
You feel like you're innocent on most every penalty, but this one always feels like, nah, did you really have to call it?
Calgary sending their power play unit out for the first time tonight.
You want to win the special teams battle almost every night. Well, the power play's first chance to check in here. We'll see what they can get done.
Tees it up from the blue line. Great reflex on display tonight on his part. And that's a solid clearing attempt on the play. Calgary's got the puck. Here they come inside the neutral zone. Takes a shot. Stopped by Smith. Handles the puck. Nothing. Nears the blue line and looks to set up at the point. Log jam in front. That's broken up. And that pass can't connect. And a bad pass, and they'll be forced to start all over again outside the offensive end. Takes the feed. Calgary's got the puck against the half wall. From point blank, they score!
Good effort onto the puck to get into the zone clean and then set it up and are able to cash in. He's going to look at that up on the board. He's not going to like his positioning, I don't think, James. When he sees the replay, he'll see he was a little deep.
The Flames are up by a pair now here late in the second.
Don't put your feet up now. You're so close to this intermission. Run it in.
Monahan's won the draw. And now he passes up to Kachuk. And they cough it up at center. Sends the pass over. And makes the save. Knocked away with the stick by Nurse. The Oilers will play it in their own end. Looks to get the puck over to Puljujarvi. The Flames gain control of the puck. The Oilers have it in the offensive end. That's gloved by Markstrom. The Flames move the puck in the defensive zone. Shot! Glove save made by Smith. There's the whistle as things will slow down here for a moment.
Always a good play if you're not sure what's going on. Freeze the puck. Markstrom's taking a look up at the big board on the replay. You'll see his stick save was excellent. That was a good scoring chance.
Here in the late goings of the period, the Flames have all the momentum right now, leading by two. Picked up along the wall by Barry. inside the defensive zone, moving the puck. Here we go, one-man rush. Calgary's got possession of the puck. Lindholm's got it into offensive territory. Makes the save. Works it across to Puljujärvi. Gains the zone through the middle. To the front. Here he is, wrists it on net. It's in. He scores.
Man, it looks like a bus depot in front of the net. You know it's a tough one when you can't see the goalie. That means he can't see the puck.
That goal all comes back to his long stretch pass, guys. He picks up the assist with ascended superstar ability because he was able to find his teammate up the ice and gave them a chance to get onto the attack.
Edmonton's got the puck inside the defensive zone. With some open space at center. And it's a quick pass to Kane. And surfs up a little knock on the play. And they'll go the other way with it. First period comes to an end. I'll tell you what, anybody who bought a ticket for this one is feeling like they got their money's worth. And as both teams head to their respective rooms, two more periods still to come. We're looking forward to it here on EA Sports. And we are just moments away from the start of period number two. Well, after an intriguing opening period, here we go. It's period number two. Puck is dropped, and we are underway. Ray, what's your assessment of the game to this point?
The Oilers are going to have to find a possession game that looks a lot different than that first period. They chased it around, and as a result, they're chasing the game.
And he stands tall in goal. There's the whistle from the linesman calling it offside. James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro with you here in the early going of this period. The Flames lead it 2-1 in what has been an entertaining game thus far. Puck grabbed by Nurse. Pass across to Barry. Edmonton's got the puck along the wall. Sends a pass over. Here's a chance, and there's the save.
Really smooth stop here as he deflects this puck into the corner out of danger.
Oh, and he whiffs on it. The Oilers have a hold of it in the defensive zone. They go on the attack through center. Hammers a shot, and that's blocked away. Here's a short pass to Coleman. Calgary's got the puck against the boards. Close save. In front, and a stoppage on the play as the goaltender covers things up.
He'll check his stick after this. He makes the save on a really good scoring chance.
Plenty of playing time left in this frame. Calgary's up 2-1, and the crowd has been enjoying this one. And momentum on their side as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Scooped up along the wall by Hanifin. Wicked stop by the goalie who got his glove out to knock it away. And he slides it quickly to Hanifin. And that's wide of the net. And now he moves it quickly to Tanev. An easy save by Smith. Grabbed along the board by Toffoli. The Oilers will play it from the defensive zone. And uses the length of his stick to knock that puck away. And that's stopped by Markstrom. Hanifin's got it in the defensive end. Here they are on the attack. Moves it to Goudreau. And that's picked off in front. Edmonton's in transition. Dumps it in. The Flames get a hold of the puck along the boards. Can't connect on the pass. There's another for the hit parade. Moves the puck. Nugent Hopkins plays it into the offensive zone. The Flames gain possession. Takes it into the slot. Oh, and he somehow got a
of it, and it stays out of the net.
I need to take another look at that. I thought there was room to get by. Clearly, I was wrong. I'm glad I don't have to take the hit he just took.
James and Ray with you tonight. More than half the period has been played. The Flames are clinging to a 2-1 lead. Oh, what a stop at the glove by Smith. Goaltender covers it up, and we'll get a reset here. Some last-second communication before both teams get ready to drop the puck here. Back underway as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Made the save on the play.
Smith's locked in. Every puck hits him and stays in front of him on the arch. Scores! Right off the pipe, and a good break as that puck can bounce anywhere, but he got the inside part of it, and it goes into the goal. Well, I can think of about four different things he could have done with the puck than that. That turnover is costly as it ends up in his own net.
The Flames have to be feeling good about themselves right now, Ray. A two-goal cushion as they're approaching the intermission here.
They've played well, and they deserve to be in the lead that they're in. Now, as you get close to the intermission, the coach will remind them, don't fall asleep yet.
Hyman's got it against the boards. From one point man to another. Takes the feed. Edmonton's got a hold of the puck now. Oh, denies them with the paddle save. Coleman's got it on the offensive end. Takes a shot. Big time stop there. And he slides it quickly to Anderson. Takes the pass. Lets it go. He scores.
I thought they were going to run out of time here, James. This is a terrific time to strike here. Now you carry over the intermission. You come out for the next period feeling really good about yourself. Hey, we get a good look here where the man advantage break is cultivated. Now they've got it clean in. They don't make a mistake, and the goalie has no chance as it's in the net.
Calgary's offensive volcano continues to erupt here in the second period.
They look like a juggernaut. They're running into this second intermission with a large lead.
Well, the ice has sure looked tilted after 40 minutes of play as the second period comes to an end. Third period is just around the corner, so don't even think about putting that controller down. And they are ready to drop the puck on period number three. It's been a total mismatch here as we get underway for the third. Let's see if anything changes. Well, we've got two periods under our belts to this point so far, Ray. How do you see things?
The Oilers are in the position they deserve right now, James. They're behind in the game. They haven't had the puck much. They're running around trying to get it back.
Skates to the crease. Denies them in close.
Yeah, he got out tight to him, James. There's nowhere for that puck to go.
Here's a shot. Denied by the goaltender. And just a good old-fashioned solid body check on the play. Grabs control of it at the point. Puts it on net, and too much traffic in front blocks that one. Edmonton's got it in their own zone. Puljujarvi's got the puck along the wing. Dumps it into the O-zone. Receives the pass. Taken by Toffoli. On the attack along the boards. And that doesn't exactly go tape to tape. The Oilers take possession here in the open ice. Couldn't make that one happen. The Oilers have it now. Taken along the wall by Puljujarvi. Takes a shot. denies him with the blocker. What a stop by Markstrom. Cutting to the front of the net. Oh, what a stick save. And no luck on that pass attempt. And now it's to Puljujärvi. Slides the puck over and makes the save.
That is sweeping up the trash there. Good save. Off to the corner. Everybody can readjust.
Off a stick. The Oilers take possession in the defensive end. Quick feed to Hyman. Nowhere for that shot to go through. Through the middle of the ice, they enter the attacking zone. And that's turned aside by Smith. Edmonton's got it in their own zone. Calgary's got a hold of it along the wall. Moves it to the offensive zone. And he regains control of the puck. He scores! That's 3-3.
Yeah, just they haven't taken their foot off the gas pedal at all here. Once they got that first one, they kept pushing away. Now they've got three. That's a really good shot. The goaltender's down in the butterfly. He thinks he's got mostly everything covered, but apparently not. The puck gets by him.
Calgary's on fire tonight, and they show no signs slowing down in the third.
This has been almost the perfect hockey game for them. When they look at the video, they're going to be really happy.
Takes a shot. Oh, serves up waffles for dinner with that stop. Takes it to the net. Oh, another consecutive stop.
So good. A couple of quick stops keep the puck out.
Moves the puck along the half wall. And that one's broken up by a great defensive play. Along the right wing, they enter the attacking area. Here's a shot, and that's turned aside by Smith. Edmonton's got a hold of the puck. Nice pass. The Oilers play it along the boards. And that's broken up. Sends it quickly to Toffoli. Driving right to the front. Big time saving goal as he gets all of it with the stick.
No room for the shooter. The goaltender snuffed it out.
Here he is from the slot. And as he opts to freeze the puck, we get a whistle.
Starting to look like a little bit of a fire drill in the zone, so this is a good play. Smith's blocker comes into good use there. Good positioning, and he's able to deflect it away.
In the final moments of this period, the Flames are on the cusp of making this a blowout, leading by four. Puck is dropped, and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Off a stick, and they can't connect. The Flames take it along the wall. Here's a shot. Blocker saved by Smith. And that shot dies in traffic. Edmonton's got the puck along the wall. Takes the feed. The Oilers are on the attack. Picked up by Goudreau. Here's a shot. Shuts him down. That's all she wrote from this one tonight. 1-0. It's not do or die, but how important is that win?
Well, you feel better about yourself. You feel like you've got the leg up, which you do. And now you put so much pressure on your opponents for game two.
Another W and another salute to the fans.
Yeah, the players and fans connect over this celebration. Like in Hartford, we had the Brass Bonanza. They played that after we scored or won a game. 40 years later, people still connect themselves to the Whalers.
Wait a minute, isn't that your ringtone?
No, my ringtone is my goal call.
Not shocking. For Ray Ferraro, my name is James Cebulski. Thanks so much for hanging out with us in short playoff hockey. I love it.